What's that on that beat, ho?
I ain't even not. Take the car here to the state. Then you seen a nigga thought. Throwing that ass for days.
Booty going up, down.
I ain't got no problem spending all of my money.
Tryna see what's up now.
I can do this all day like it ain't nothing. Black car, party in the backyard. Shawty got the black bra showing. Tatted up, ass fat enough. She a bad bitch and she already know it.
Is anyone else 2000s kid? What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be doing another episode of Record Rewind. The musician of choice today is a rapper from Long Beach, California. He's got a couple hits here and there, been in the game since I don't know when. Mr. Vincent Staples. And I know what everybody's probably thinking right now. Nate, you have the big fish theory vinyl, picture disc vinyl. That means that you're a Vince Staples fan. How is it that you've never listen to this album that only came out two years ago? How'd you never listen to it? You said you're a Vince Staples fan. What gives? What gives is that I only listened to it once when it came out, and I really don't remember anything from it. And I bought the vinyl a couple months ago, and I just decided to add it to the list for the series because, hey, I don't really remember anything from the first time I listened to it, and we have the best conditions to revisit it now. You know, got my vinyl record player. We have the album right here. We got a cool back on this. We got a gatefold with some circles. We have the actual sleeve with credits and a disc made of...
I'm black. As far as anything else, I have no fucking idea where this is going.
Nothing too special. But fuck it. I always gotta turn the Bluetooth off because you never know. So without further introduction, because I'm clearly shooting from the hip, the Vince Staples LP by Vince Staples. Let's go.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
He's chill. Shut the door.
Are you in there? I won't get back. I'm going out and crack. Are you in there? I won't make racks. I'm gonna fuck. I'm gonna stack. Are you in there? Won't forget to get there.
Excuse me. Okay. I do know this song. There's this song and then one other one I remember saving. So.
Fuck a friend. I don't want no friends with no open hands. Count my money. Don't you call my phone. Everyone that I ever know. Leave me alone for everything. Louis bag, Gucci bag, you got baggage. I will never give my money to a bad bitch. I will never give my money to a bad bitch. There we have. You will never catch me zipping out the track.
Fix me.
We are 3 for 3. So far, it seems like there's been no pause, so every track just flows together.
Don't get murdered. Young niggas out here with no purpose, no deserving.
Oh!
Rather get flipped and go flip burgers, tell your
story. Oh!
Niggas ain't built like that in person, city burning, honey. It's not what you thought. We dying broke a little with broken hearts.
I notice he's either pitching his voice up a little, like a teeny little bit, or like he's just, you know, speaking with a different, what is it called,
Kate? It's not what you think. I could be gone to blink, I don't wanna leave. It's not what you thought. We dying broke a little with broken hearts.
This is the fifth song, and besides Law of Averages, we've got some pretty, a lot of similar beats. I'm mad at it, but you know, they're still nice. Side B.
Oh.
Yeah, okay, I know this song. This is the one that I listen to the most. Because it has Fushi on it, her voice is so great, as you know.
I don't wanna die, but I will for the cause. I hate when you hide, but you hate feeling lost. I hate every time that you ask, can we talk? You know these shoes come with baggies, you know, cross the daddy.
What the fuck? Get out of here.
Full of vultures, so you know I'll walk her back.
That was cool.
I believe you have my stapler.
So I feel like I can skip straight to the verdict corner for this album because honestly, I feel like it's pretty easy to explain that I don't really have to go back to what, you know, maybe the little things that I missed. I think I got a pretty broad idea of what this album is, what it's about. I mean, first off, self-titled record, you know? Everybody who does that, like, you know, that's basically them saying, you know, this is who I am. This is what I represent. This is just me. And I think I get why he called it that, because the lyrical content, it's more so just speaking on how he currently feels at his level of success. Also as well speaking on his past and using these little audio clips, you know, sprinkled as samples into the songs, maybe of people in his past, whether they would be here or not be here right now. It was a lot of reminiscing, you know, talking about, hey, I used to do this, I used to do that. That's why it doesn't really seem like he's saying that much.
Also, just because the album itself seemed very short. Well, it was very short. That's why I didn't really feel like he was saying anything, but that's just me.
Just rapping to try and tell a story. And I think that's perfectly fine. Instrumental-wise, I didn't know until I just looked at the program down here that almost all the production was done by Kenny Beats. Only reason why anybody wouldn't suspect that it was Kenny Beats is because he doesn't have the "Whoa, Kenny!" at the beginning of every single beat. And honestly, I'm glad that he didn't do that. Being that he has made a project with Vince before, it was called FM, and he pretty much had his producer tag on every single beat. When you collab with an artist, like, you don't have to have that in every single song. Like, we know, all right? There's so many albums that are, you know, examples of that. Usher and Zaytoven. I also hate to include this one, but Call Me If You Get Lost. So I'm glad that they didn't do that, and that it really is a thing that matters to people that dive deep into, you know, the behind the scenes of the album. So good move by Mr. Kenneth Instrumental. All of them are somewhat similar in the style, but then again, that's also because it was made by one specific guy, so it's his style the whole way through. But they're clean, every beat hits. Overall, this was just a good time. And after this one came Ramona Park last year, which I didn't really listen to either. So if you guys want to see me react to that, let me know in the comments down below. And lastly, just a word to Vince Staples, keep doing what you're doing. I don't want you to stop, at least not for a while. And it would be cool to collaborate with a different producer, do a different collaboration, and maybe even just a different style of beat, because Vince is at a point in his rap career where he can start experimenting with different sounds. I know that that's weird considering that Big Fish Theory exists, and that was probably his most ambitious album. Get out there, try some new things. Overall, this album was pretty good, and I definitely recommend it to anybody that likes, you know, simple rap, trap, hip-hop music. Thank you all for watching. Like, subscribe. Till my next video, peace out on Slices. Going up, down. I ain't got no problem spending all of my money.